When you wake up in the morning, do you ever expect that your workday will begin with having to escort a cat that got in your house in 3 seconds that you open a door back outside before recording a video? I didn't experience that. You want to read about it, I'll put the link in the description. But let's get to the topic of the day. Topic of the day, everyone. Not to do away with what we just witnessed with Disney Plus literally announcing America Chavez for Disney Plus. Let's talk about Chappelle's special last night. If you weren't laughing, you weren't living. God, this special was something else, guys. It was magical. It was wonderful. It was splendiferous. But before anything else, it was on time and poignant. I say that because the entire idea on the special was Chappelle wants to crack jokes and wants to roast people. Because the entire special itself is possibly the best kind of anti-woke dragging you could hope for. Let me put a tweet on screen for you so that you can see what it is I'm talking about. You can accurately see what it is that I'm mentioning here. Because I want to talk about this today. Because it's going to be interesting. I want to see where this topic takes us. Last night, when people were informed either by their employers or otherwise that the special was live, we all watched it. I don't know about you, I torrented it only because I'm not supporting Netflix. Let me just say that straight up out front. But the special, it was grand. It was wonderful. If you haven't seen it yet, I encourage you to. I'm not going to spoil it here except for three screenshots that I took of something that was not exe that it wasn't even a joke. It was more like a take and reaction. But Chappelle joked a lot. He joked about a lot of things. He joked about PC culture. He joked about how activists behave in the times of crisis and shootings. He talked about the epidemic of heroin, comparing it to the crack epidemic with blacks. He did it all, and it was funny as shit. I was right here on my bed, losing my shit, because I couldn't deal. I couldn't deal. My sides were in orbit. And then, riding this high, I'm scrolling through the timeline, going over the posts that need to be archived. See Zoe Quinn bringing up a brouhaha, outing supposedly another sex pest from the industry. I keep scrolling, and I eventually come across this post here. But someone getting mad as hell that Dave Chappelle was exhibiting the exact same kind of energy in his jokes that a whole bunch of other artists did. And this mad crudge muffin is upset because they want to put words in the mouth of both Adam and Dave because they didn't like the fact that their sacred cows got roasted. And this is an important note to take note of because you see, it's not just Dave's special, right? Because my point that I'm getting at here is if you're really that mad at the jokes that Dave told last night, the reason you're mad about them is because you don't have control over him. Because it's not just about this, right? Like, it's not just that you're mad about the special. You're not mad about the comedy. You're mad about his opinions and the fact that he was able to have them and that people were laughing at the very ideas. Right? Like, remember for a moment the purpose and the point of what comedy is supposed to do. It's the great unifier to cleanse the great divide. And the reason you don't like it is because at the end of the day, the point of the comedy is to poke fun at and about everything. There was a joke that Dave told. I'll spoil this one for you. I want you to see what I'm talking about, right?
And it make him get into sitting between the B's and the T's. I feel bad for T's, but it's so confusing. And it's not all my fault. I feel like they need to take some responsibility for my jokes. Because I didn't come up with this idea on my own. This idea that a person can be born in the wrong body. But they have to admit, that's a fucking hilarious predicament. It's really fucking funny. And if it happened to me, you'd laugh, wouldn't you? That wouldn't be funny if it happened to me. I think it would be. What if it did? What if I was Chinese, but born in this nigga body? That's not funny. And for the rest of my life, I had to go around making that face. Hey, everybody, I'm Chinese. And everyone get mad. Stop making that face. That's offensive. What? This is how I feel inside.
Jokes like that. They're mad about jokes like that. And if you're not familiar with how people get irate about something, like, you know, offending the people who get mad at jokes like this on the internet, you might not understand. Because you see, it's not about the joke. It's not even about the fact that Dave told it. It's about the fact that the sacred cow could even be joked about. And it's the essence of the joke. It's the fact that the joke exists. Let me explain what I'm talking about, right? Hopefully I have it in here. Like, you've got game developers being called homophobic because people can't deal with the fact about something that wasn't even supposed to be there, right? Things that are being removed entirely that aren't there, they're complaining about. And where's the other one? You got people being upset and mad about how people ask them, how is the Minecraft bees trans? Right? You ask them questions. And they act like this. And the reason it's hilarious, I think I figured it out. All right? I think I figured it out. Are you ready? I'm going to explain it. I'm going to break it down for you. Because it was a brain blast when I felt this too. The reason why they hate it being joked about is because jokes are how we cope, and they can't cope because they don't have senses of humor anymore, because whatever they had to do to become what they are now as warriors fighting a culture war, they had to get rid of their humor and do away with any sensations whatsoever in order to have that mentality that allows them to flip the world upside down and right back side again so they can be able to keep fighting. They do it because they have to have something to fight about. That's why. It sounds ridiculous, but really, let's think about it. Let's actually think about the motives there. Because if you want to be understood, right? If you want people to accept you, if you don't want to be like Anna Valens, let me pull up Anna Valens here. Let me go to my tweet so I can have it on screen for you as a reference. allow me to search, please. Why are you doing to this to me? Hi. Here we go. When you end up being like on a Valens right here, when it gets to the point that you are using actual incel language as depicted here in this thread, take a moment as I scroll down if you want to look at it all, right? If you end up being like her, saying things like this, and you behave anything even similar to this, to the point where you're getting people banned off the platform because they ask you the questions that you demand people ask you, you have to understand that is funny as fuck. Because you're stirring yourself up into a frenzy. And people legitimately want to care for the problem. They legitimately want to understand. They legitimately want to give you the chance to say your piece. But every time we give you the chance to say your piece, you're immature, you badger, you get irate, you get emotional, and then you attack anything and everyone that moves. That does not help us. But you know what does? Clowning. Clowning on it does. Because when we can all collectively laugh at it together, even you, the ones out in the audience who may be hearing and listening to this thinking, ah, this is not how we do it. That's not what we want. Well, you have to understand, it's like that because you do. You think that ain't how it be, but it do. It do, because that's what it becomes. The special in itself encapsulates everything that is fucked up and that is inherently funny, with the observations of the big gay mafia, as I call it. I've described it before. I'll try to explain it. There, you have the big gay mafia, and then you have the big gay militants, right? You got the L's, the B's, and the G's, and the T's that want people to understand. They want to bridge that gap. There's Sophia Narwitz, right? You got people like Sophia Narwitz that want you to have fun and laugh with them. You got people like Filthy Fujoshi, Boechi Tasty. I don't know Filthy Fujoshi's name, but you got people like Sophia and Christina who want you to understand. They're trying to connect to you, reaching out on the gap, and they're saying, guys, come on, just a little bit further. And then you got the people over here, the kind of people who do shit like this that we're referencing. They're kind of people like this guy. Y'all are the ones that when Dave said, it feels like y'all are just, it feels like, you, it makes them feel like y'all holding them back. As real. Because that's what it's like. Everybody's trying to try and come to a better understanding and a better perspective. But you don't even want to be made fun of. You won't allow yourself to be made fun of. And because you won't let people joke, because you want to control language, because you want to fearmonger, because you want to put everybody in a political holding pattern, when you say, that's not good enough, that's little too much, nobody knows what to do. So you just want to hold everybody by the balls. And when people joke about it, and when they point out the fact that, haha, isn't it funny how they hold us by the balls, yet this is how they act, you get mad. Like, you put your hands on your hips, you ball up your fists, and you cry, saying, you can't do that! I don't want to laugh, because I feel like some of the things that some of us say and we joke about is just way too funny. But at the end of the day, You didn't die. We hope that you don't. Nobody wants you harmed. We're just ribbing. The ribbing won't kill you. It'll actually humanize you. The thing that I don't feel like they understand is that with every chuckle, the transphobia drains out of our bodies. Every time we wipe away our tear, that's that toxic masculinity that you accuse everybody of being flushed out of the system. And all that remains is just a whole bunch of people just jostling each other, laughing on the internet. What's so bad about that? Why are you so mad about that? You might think, now you audience member, you might think, oh, what's, come on, Carl. Come on, be serious. You know that they don't laugh. Oh, they do. It's just that their sense of humor doesn't allow them to laugh at it. Because it's like a religion. It's like a doctrine. They cannot make fun of themselves. Because to insult the creator is to be the highest forms of haram. It's halal to get mad at people and use cancel culture to put them in their place. But it's haram to make jokes about each other. Because now, if you make jokes about yourself and you laugh at yourself, but you make jokes about other people and you get mad about when people make jokes about you, it makes you look kind of hypersensitive. I mean, in the special, here in these clips, he tells you, now in the audience, you at home and you at the show, it doesn't matter what he says. And if you're watching the shit on Netflix, you have to remember, you clicked on his face. It's quite literally an update of, why did I go places and go see things that I knew would make me upset? You can't get mad at this. You brought this on yourself. The sooner you accept it and you cope, the sooner you can join the rest of us. We don't bite. Only if you tell us to. Except the zoo sadists, they actually bite you. Don't touch them. It is what it is, Holmes. It is what it is. You can either laugh or die. It's your choice. Now, if you excuse me, I gotta go research some shit. Things are happening. See you guys next time. Adios.